This is Stubby the dog. He's shy.
Make a little more sense. There you go.
Oh wow, it's deep. We got some big fish in there. There you go.
This'll, when this fills up, you can probably go around with the steps over here. You can see it there. There's a siphon tube in there.
Yep.
An auto siphon tube. It comes up over and back down, and then it runs out down here.
So pretty soon here, well, you'll see it. They're starting to run water out through those.
Oh, yeah. So wait, that's just been running the whole time. Nothing just happened, right?
It's just starting to pull it in.
Because it got high enough?
Yeah, once the water level gets down low enough in the barrel, it'll stop. So it's just started.
So most of them have those in them, and then I have one here that has sprayers, and I have to clean the holes out all the time. But this one here, I'm just trying to get water to run down. These here, the other ones, they fill up with water from the bottom up because
you got pressure early on.
Well, that's a quarter inch hole there, and the drain hole is an eighth inch.
Uh-huh.
So the idea is you get the water table to come up to about an inch from the top, and then drain back down, so you're constantly just kind of running the fish poo and water into the tank.
And then that all water's just going right back into the tank.
It goes right back in.
Tomatoes. And the vines don't look as well right now. Leafy stuff does really well in this.
Got lettuce and
there. This is collard greens and kale.
Kale.
We're all about
that in California.
These are actually just cuttings from those other plants. You just stick them in the ground and they
look like tomatoes.
Yeah, they are.
Carrots are parsley.
That's carrots.
Yeah, Bill was saying the root stuff wasn't doing so well.
Yeah, I'm still working on how that works out. Peppers do fairly well. We've got good number of peppers setting on. Eggplant has just taken off recently. Here's a big guy right there.
Oh, wow. That's enormous.
And then basil. This is lemon basil. You can smell it. And then there's regular basil. That's,
I don't remember. Looks like a squash or something.
Well, it's a
weed.
Okra.
Okra.
Yeah. And then
sounds like you had people from the south helping you install it.
Yeah.
Collard greens and okra.
Yeah.
Looks like parsley.
That's cilantro.
Cilantro.
Yeah. So I've gotten some carrots to grow
fig.
Really
is this
big. That's a papaya. Somebody planted that in here without me knowing. This is a radish. Actually, I'm going to pull this one out because we're going to cook some of it.
All right.
But I have the first ones that we planted, I could never get them to grow anything on here. So now when I plant them and they pop up, you have to keep piling gravel around them because they go down into the ground. They come out of the ground. So I'm trying the same thing with the beets and the carrots.
And then you got this. You've got a
little sunshade.
Got a sunshade up there. Got our security wire.
Yeah.
Is this related or is this just
it? No.
So what's your name? I guess that's the first thing.
My name is Stan Hyder.
And you said you had a degree in agriculture, although that's not really how this thing came to be.
No, not really. No. A team from California had the idea. They'd had some training on it, and so they thought they'd like to try it here. And ultimately, they would like to put it in the city. So I
Great. And how much food are you actually getting out of this setup?
That's a good question.
Did you say it's enough?
We have enough for salad, obviously, and a few other things. We use it, some of the tomatoes with the team house and the basil.
Yep.
As well, yeah. The water goes through three cycles. One, first, it with the fish in it, it will build up ammonia, and then there's bacteria that break that down, but you have to build the bacteria up over a period of time. And then it will change, the bacteria turn the ammonia into nitrites, which you don't use either. And then there's more bacteria that turn the nitrate or nitrites into nitrates, and that's what the plants want. Use. Yes.
And so you said there are two schools of thought. One
is that you monitor the water and keep real close tabs on it and add different things to
buffers
it. The other one is you just let it go.
And you're probably in the let it go school.
We wanted to make this as realistic as we could for Haiti.
Yep.
And so we just let it go.
Cool.
I do have a swimming pool test kit, which will tell me pH and a few other things that most of the stuff on the strip doesn't apply to.
Yeah.
An aquaponics. Black soldier fly larvae for food.
Oh, you're kidding me. You're growing black soldier larvae?
Yeah.
So this is gonna, my colleague is gonna go nuts about this.
So if I pull up, I don't know if your camera will show it, but look.
Oh yeah.
See the movement down? Anyway, you can see some of the larvae down in there.
Yeah, you can see them. Oh, let's see if I get in there. There you go, Bill. Black soldier fly larva. And is that just living off the water? Or are you putting?
No, that's all just they're living off of scraps from the kitchen.
So
just vegetable scraps.
Yep. And then do you feed those to the fish?
Yes.
Yes.
So they will crawl out through this tube.
Drop in the bucket. I don't know if I've got any because.
There may not be any in here. So this is when they're ready to go on with life, they crawl out.
Yeah, and they fall in here. And I don't, well, there's one.
A little smaller one.
Small one is fish food.
All right. Our caged van. You got a container over there. That's great.